Hi, it's Matt from Collaboration Coach, and thank you for having me again on Keep Productive. In this video, we're going to look at how to create a wiki library in SharePoint Online. I'm going to show you how to create a wiki page template, a library that stores the wiki pages, and how to display them and add them to your SharePoint site. I'm going to explain how to do this in 5 steps. First of all, we're going to prepare the pages library. Then we're going to create a wiki page template. And then we're going to create a wiki page based on that template. We're going to create a simple wiki view on the pages library so we can just see the wiki pages. And then finally, we're going to add the wiki page to the navigation so it's easy to get to. Before we get into that, I just wanted to say that we have a channel on YouTube called Collaboration Coach. So if you like these videos, go check us out over there. And we have some premium courses for sale at our school at school.collaboration.coach. So step number one is to prepare the pages library. We're going to go to the site contents page. So from the home page, you can either go settings wheel and site contents, or you can go to site contents over here on the left hand side. And in the contents list, you go to the site pages library. And then in there, you're going to see a list of site pages already created, possibly. And what we're going to do is add a new column to this library called Wiki Page. So I'm going to come up here, I'm going to choose Add Column, and I'm going to choose Yes, No, because it's a Wiki page or it's not. I'm going to call this Wiki Page. And the default value, this is important, is going to be No. The reason it's No is that this site pages library has all the site pages. So all the news items and all the other pages that created, not all of them are going to be wiki pages. So by default, we want the value to be no. So I'm going to hit save, and you'll see now we have the wiki page column there. Step two is to create a wiki page template. We're going to create a new page from the site pages library. So right where we are here, we're going to go up to the new button and drop it down. Now, confusingly, there's already a wiki page option here. You're going to see this in your library as well. That is the classic version of the wiki page, so we don't want to use that. We're going to create a new modern version of a wiki page. So we want to choose this one here at the bottom, site page. When we choose that, it opens up a new tab and we land on a new page. And the first thing we need to do is turn this into a template. We do that by coming up to where it says save as draft. Drop that down and choose Save as Template. When we do that, you'll notice a couple of changes to the page. So we first of all, we see that this is now a page template. We see the Save button has changed to Save Page Template, and we can also name our page template. So I'm going to call this template Wiki Page. I'm going to remove this name because I don't want it to be associated with anyone in particular. I'm going to make a few changes to the title area. So I'm going to come to the edit button and I'm going to make the title area plain. You see that just drops the image in the background. Next, I'm going to split the section below, so this area here, into two by pressing on this button here and choosing 1/3 right column. That means I've got a larger area on the left and a smaller one on the right, but I've got two columns. In the left-hand side, I'm going to add a text web part. So you can see that there. And over here, I'm going to do the same and hit plus. But this time, I'm going to add an image. I'm just going to cancel that because I don't want to choose the image. I want to let the person who creates the page choose the image. And further down here, I'm going to plus again. And this time, I'm going to choose quick links. That just gives me a list of links. I'm going to scroll to the bottom here and turn off comments. I don't want people to be able to comment on this page. And I also need to set the wiki page value to yes. So you remember we created the column earlier called wiki page in this library. We want all pages created using this template to have that value set to yes. So we do that by going to the template details button, which brings up this information pane on the right hand side. And you can see here wiki page is set to no, because that was our default value. So you just click on here, you get a toggle, and you just switch it to yes, and it's saved. Now that every page that's created using this template will have that set to yes, and that's important for later on. So I'm done now, so I'm just going to hit Save Page Template, and my page template is saved. Step 3 is to create a wiki page. So let's test out the wiki page template and create a new wiki page. To do that, we go to the home button, and then once we land on the home page, we go to new and page. So this is going to take us to the pages window, and you can see we've got some featured out of the box pages here, but we've also got some custom ones, one of which is my wiki page. Now if I click on it, it's not going to show us much because remember there isn't anything in it at the moment other than the web parts we chose. So all I need to do is select it and choose create page. Now you can see it's dropped us into the new page. I can name it here, I can add my text here, and I can add an image and some links. So this formatting bit is fairly straightforward, so I'm going to speed up the video so you don't have to sit through it. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. Remember, this is an events site, an events wiki, so I've just created a page for a venue in London that might be useful to people using it. I've just put in a picture, some links, and some fake text. So although we added some standard web parts like the image and the text, one of the good things about a modern page is that users can add their own web parts that they think might be relevant. So we can give them the template, but then they can add to it. For example, if I scroll down here, I might want to add a map showing where XL London actually is. And I can do that by hitting the plus button. And there is a maps web part, which I can choose here, Bing Maps. And then I can type in the location of XL and just hit that. And then you'll see it's added a map. Maps might not be relevant to every wiki page, but they are a big advantage of using a modern page. So when we're happy with our page, we can hit publish. It publishes the page, and now we have a new wiki page. Step 4 is to create a simple wiki view on the site pages library. So let's go back to the library that this page is in. I'm going to go to the site contents and then go to the site pages library. Now if I scroll down, I should be able to see my XL London page there, but you can see it's mixed up with all the other pages. So these are site pages, news pages, and so on. What I want to do is to be able to see just my wiki pages in this library. So if you remember, we created our wiki page column, and because my XL London page was based on the template that had the wiki page column set to yes, the pages I create are also set to yes. So this is good because this means we can create a view based on that column that will only show us the wiki pages. To do that, we need to create a new view to start with. So I'm going to come up here to the views dropdown. You can see here all the views, and this one's actually by author. And what I need to do is save this view as and choose another name. So I'm going to choose save view as here, and I'm going to call this wiki pages. I want it to be a public view because otherwise only I'll see it. Hit save, and now I've got a new view you see up here in the top corner. Now what I want to do is filter this view by my wiki page column. So we do that by coming to the wiki page column, doing the drop down, and choosing filter by. That will show us the filter by wiki page options, which are empty, no, and yes, and we want to choose yes. So we want to say, if wiki page column is set to yes, then show me the page. So let's hit apply. Now we should see just our wiki page, because you can see wiki page is set to yes. Now we don't need wiki page column in this view, so we can go to the drop down, choose column settings, and say hide this column. The next thing I want to do is remove the grouping. So right now you can see I've got a group by created by, and I can remove that by going up to the wiki pages view drop down and choosing edit current view, and then I scroll down to the very bottom of this page and choose group by. Usually have to hit the plus button to expand it, and you can see here I've got this first group by column created by. So if I change that to none, that means there will be no grouping. And so then I press OK, and now you can see I don't see the grouping. Finally, step 5 is to add the wiki to the navigation. To do that, I'm going to create a new page. I'm going to go to New and Site Page, and I'm going to add the Site Pages library. I'm going to come to the plus button, and I'm going to choose the Document Library web part here. So what that does is then offers me all the libraries in that site, one of which is Site Pages. So I choose Site Pages, and that shows me the Site Pages document library. Now what I want to do is come up to this pencil icon so I can edit the web part. And I want to change the view to my Wiki Pages view. And I also want to switch off the command bar, and then I'm going to apply. Now you can see I've got a nice tidy page with just my Wiki Pages view. And I'm going to also scroll up to the top here. I'm going to name the page Events Wiki. I'm going to edit this web part, and I'm going to change the layout to plain, and that looks pretty good. So I'm going to hit publish. Now I'm going to also copy this address over here on the right hand side, and I'm going to close this, and I'm going to add this page to the navigation. So I do that by coming to the navigation and hitting edit. Then I can hover over here and hit plus. Then I'm going to paste that URL into there, and the display name is going to be Events Wiki. And press OK and save. So now I've got the Events Wiki link here, so whenever I click on it, it's going to take me through to all my Wiki pages. All right, so well done for sticking with me for this long. You've done very well. I just wanted to summarize what we've talked about so far. So the first thing we did was prepare the pages library. So we created a new column called Wiki Pages. We created a Wiki page template and we saved that in the pages library. Then we created a Wiki page based on that template. Next thing we did was create a simple Wiki view that filtered out all the pages that weren't Wiki pages. And we changed the grouping on that view so it looked nice and neat. And then we added the Wiki to the navigation so it was easy for us to get to. Okay guys, that's your lot. Thank you for having me on Keep Productive again. It's a great pleasure to talk to you. And if you like this video, then please check us out on YouTube. Our channel's called Collaboration Coach. And we also have a school where we have premium courses on SharePoint, Teams, and other Microsoft technologies at school.collaboration.coach. See you next time.